You know, our world is enormous, and there are so many types of life around us. It might sound shocking, but there are approximately 7.7 million species of animals on our planet, with only 12% of them formally described. Most of these cataloged animals live on land, and humankind has still a long way to go to explore the fauna of the oceans completely. With such an abundance of life forms, it's not surprising that people tend to confuse certain animals. Let's be honest, some of them look really similar. We hope this video will help clear up some of the confusion. Rabbits versus hares. Both rabbits and hares belong to the same family, Leporidae. So it's no wonder that these cute creatures are the ones that get confused the most. However, if you look at them attentively, you'll easily spot the differences. Hares are typically faster and larger than their close relatives. Their ears and strong hind legs are also longer, and they have bigger feet. You could also say that hares are braver than rabbits. While the latter hide in their warrens when they feel threatened, hares usually try to outrun predators, and in most cases, they succeed. To distinguish between hares and rabbits, you can also take a look at their fur. You'll notice that hares have some black marks on their bodies. Moths versus butterflies. Both of these species belong to the order Lepidoptera. Do you think you can easily tell a small gray or brown moth from a beautiful, vibrant butterfly? Well, you'd be surprised to know that there are species that look astonishingly alike. To know for sure which creature is in front of you, pay attention to the antennae. Butterflies have club-shaped antennae that look like a thin shaft with a bulbous tip. As for moths, their antennae are either serrated or feathery. Wings can serve as another hint. Moths have tent-like wings, which they fold over their abdomen. Butterflies fold their wings vertically. Sheep versus goats. It's pretty easy to confuse goats and domestic sheep, as both species have a lot of common features. Both sheep and goats are cloven-hoofed and have quite unusual eyes with horizontal rectangular pupils. But take a look at their tails. You will notice that sheep hold them down, whereas the tails of goats proudly stand up. What's more, these animals have different eating habits. Just like cows, sheep are grazers, meaning that they move across a pasture and pick the vegetation that is close to the ground. With this method, they don't have to lift their heads. As for goats, these animals are browsers, choosing plants growing higher up for their meals. Goats have even been known to climb trees if they see some especially tempting leaves. Hedgehogs versus porcupines. Well, let's get right to the point. Ouch! Both of these animals are spiny. These spines are, in fact, hardened hollow hairs. That's it. These creatures have nothing else in common. What's more, even their spines had separate evolutions. Surprisingly, porcupines are rodents. Like all rodents, they have big front teeth, which typically look as if they have never been cleaned. On second thoughts, this is probably true. Porcupines use these teeth to munch on vegetation. As for hedgehogs, their snouts and teeth are pointy, and they are omnivores, feasting on insects, frogs, plants, and fruit. These cuties are common in Africa, Asia, and Europe. But if you see a spiky creature in the wilderness of South or North America, it's a porcupine. Llamas versus alpacas. These even-toed ungulates belong to the same family, Camelidae. To tell the difference, first pay attention to their size. Mature llamas are much larger than alpacas, whose weight typically varies between 100 pounds and 170 pounds. As for an adult llama, it can weigh as much as 400 pounds. If it seems that both animals are of the same shape, look at their ears. The ears of alpacas are short and spear-shaped. Llamas boast long, curved ears. Plus, a llama's face is longer and mostly hairless. An alpaca has a bit of a smushed, fluffy face. Crocodiles versus alligators. I wouldn't get close to either of these guys. Both crocodiles and alligators belong to the same order, Crocodilia. Actually, both species have much in common except for one thing, their salt tolerance. Crocodiles are the lucky owners of special glands, which they use to excrete excess salt. That's why they feel absolutely at home in saltwater habitats, as well as mangrove swamps situated close to the coast. As for alligators, their salt glands aren't so well developed. That's why they mostly live in freshwater. You should also pay attention to the shape of their heads. In most cases, although there are some exceptions, alligators have U-shaped snouts, and crocodiles' jaws are V-shaped. Sea lions versus seals. Both seals and sea lions are fin-footed animals, or pinnipeds. However, sea lions' flippers are larger and covered with skin. Seals have a thinly webbed flipper, and each small toe has a claw. Seals are generally smaller and are happier in water than on land. You might have noticed that they prefer to crawl on these bellies when they get out of the water. As for sea lions, these creatures can walk. Sea lions have ears that look like cute little flaps. Seals don't have any external ears. Finally, seals prefer solitude, and sea lions love gathering in big companies and hanging out with friends, behaving in a pretty noisy way. Wasps versus bees. Hymenoptera is the order to which both bees and wasps belong. Bees are hairy. They need this feature to dip into flowers to collect pollen. Also, their rear legs are flat. Bees look more stocky. Wasps have smoother hourglass bodies with tiny waists, and their legs are more slender. Like supermodels. As for the attitude of these insects, wasps are more aggressive, especially when protecting their nest. Bees, on the other hand, are calmer and more docile. Frogs versus toads. Both toads and frogs belong to the order Anura, but there are some substantial differences between these species. The skin of most frogs is smooth, while a toad's skin is thick and bumpy. Frogs' legs are long and slender and delicious, and their eyes are big and bulgy. As for toads, their legs are shorter and their eyes are smaller. If you're lucky, you may notice one more difference. Frogs organize their eggs in a cluster that looks like a bunch of grapes. Toads lay eggs in a strand. Dolphins versus porpoises. Dolphins and porpoises both belong to the order Cetacea. To tell them apart, you need to pay attention to their bodies, fins, and faces. Most dolphins have pointy faces, curved dorsal fins, and slender bodies. Porpoises have triangular back fins, robust bodies, and rounded faces. In addition, porpoises have spade-shaped teeth, and their mouths are smaller. Dolphins' teeth are cone-shaped and more prominent. Turtles versus tortoises. Both turtles and tortoises are reptiles and belong to the order Chelonia. But turtles have webbed feet as they live mostly in water, and this makes swimming easier. Also, their shells are lighter and flatter. Tortoises, in turn, prefer the land. Their feet aren't webbed, as this would make it harder for them to move through uneven terrain and dig the ground. You will always recognize a tortoise thanks to its heavy dome-like shell. Leopards versus jaguars. Both species are speckled, and both are, in fact, big cats. However, your first clue should be where you see the animal. You can find jaguars in Central and South America, and sometimes in the southwest of the USA. As for leopards, they dwell in Asia and Africa. Another way to distinguish these big cats is to examine the clusters of dark spots that decorate their fur, if you dare to get that close. Inside each of these clusters, jaguars have smaller spots. Leopards are more slender and a bit smaller than jaguars. They also have longer tails. So, which pair of animals do you find the hardest to tell apart? Tell us in the comments below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. This is the best way to stay with us on the bright side of life.